You mentioned the generation of the small LDL particles, the small dense LDL particles, which, through normal biology, part of these LDL particles are donating triglycerides to cells and become smaller and smaller. I've done a lot of reading directed from Mark Shinaga. He had, talked about some very interesting mechanisms and directed me into the literature on the role of inflammation in the production of VLDL. So as inflammation goes up, VLDL production is increased. And at least in a couple of studies that I've read in literature, it seems to be implied the reason for that is that inflammation increases the release of endotoxin, which is a lipopolysaccharide from, bacterial cell walls in the gut, that gets released, and it binds to lipoproteins, to all lipoproteins, and it's sort of like an adaptive response to make sure we don't get, sepsis or some sort of very toxic infection. And so I've done, some reading on a few studies that have shown that, endotoxin does bind lipoproteins. And I'm wondering if you've looked into that at all, or what role the endotoxin in binding these lipoproteins seems to play in keeping the smaller dense lipoproteins in the circulation longer
Okay.
or.
All right. Well, that's a very interesting topic. And just take a step back regarding the role of inflammation in lipoprotein metabolism, because that's something that is not widely appreciated. We know that inflammation is an important feature of many chronic diseases, including heart disease and the artery wall inflammation. It really is the major factor that converts a relatively benign cholesterol deposit into a much more nasty and dangerous form that can cause blood clots and rupture and plaque formation and blocks arteries. Inflammation is a key feature of that. So inflammation is really an important feature of many aspects of the processes we're talking about. But biologically, again, inflammation is not designed to cause heart attacks. It's designed to help us with host defense. So there's a very interesting argument that has been made that part of the physiological driver for VLDL secretion by the liver, the production of these triglyceride-rich particles, is really not a nutritional role, although I think it does have an important nutritional role. But perhaps even as importantly, it may serve an important role in host defense. And so I'll come to the LPS question at the end of this little discussion, because the really interesting sort of corollary of that is what role does lipoproteins have in the host defense mechanism? And what's intriguing, it's sort of a like a biological fact that we don't want to make too much out of, but I think it's very intriguing, is that the liver constantly makes the major protein that forms the backbone of these VLDL and ultimately LDL particles, called ApoB. Apolipoprotein B is a very big protein that is biologically ancient. It goes back to lobsters, and it's a very important and complicated protein that gives the integrity to the lipoprotein particle. It helps keep all the fat contained and allows the fat to be soluble in the bloodstream. That's the secret of lipoprotein particles, is that there is a soluble protein that helps to keep the fat from forming droplets like you see in chicken soup. It helps to dissolve the fat in a way. Anyway, the ApoB protein is constantly synthesized by the liver. It's under a tonic stimulation. It's not much regulated. It's just continually being produced and degraded, which seems like a very inefficient process. But one of the thoughts that has intrigued me and others is that that the regulation of ApoB and the particles that are formed on ApoB, the VLDL particles, is really to get these particles out in a hurry when they're needed. Because VLDL, it's a huge It's a huge particle, relatively speaking, to most other biological proteins. Its molecular weight is can be tens of millions as opposed to 50,000. So it takes a lot of work for the liver to make one of these VLDL particles. And what the liver doesn't want to do is spend hours making a VLDL particle if it needs to come out in a hurry. Well, why would it need to come out in a hurry? Well, one of the arguments is it may be because it contains components, which it does, that help promote inflammation in the circulatory system. Why would that be important? Well, because when you have an organism, be it a parasite or another infectious agent in the vascular system, malaria, parasites, trypanosomes, whatever you care to mention, viruses, one way the body has of eliminating them is by setting up an inflammatory response and an immune response related to that. And VLDL carry pro-inflammatory proteins. They carry also prothrombotic proteins. They actually are a very efficient delivery system, sort of like a fire truck that carries a lot of things that we can use to fight off infection. Now, biologically, in our current era of antibiotics and antisepsis, that function has sort of faded. But the rapidity of this response and the fact that it's regulated not by production of ApoB but by degradation suggests that this is designed to come out in a hurry. And so degradation of ApoB is inhibited when there's lipid to be released. So the ability of the liver to secrete ApoB and the lipids associated with VLDL is increased when there is this additional lipid production that occurs. And that lipid production is stimulated by cytokines. So it comes back to the body having a foreign agent in it. That foreign agent these days is more likely to be a plaque in the artery rather than a bacterial agent. But the response is the same. It says we got cytokines, we got inflammation. Those come to the liver. And one of the early studies that got me interested in this aspect of things is that we showed collaboration with people at UCSF that cytokines such as TNF-alpha in particular, but interferon as well, stimulate the production of VLDL secretion by the liver. And so, again, infectious agent, inflammatory signals, cytokines are produced. Increasing lipid synthesis, reducing the degradation of ApoB, allowing the rapid export of these VLDL particles, all of that occurs in minutes. And so that's the sort of thing you want the fire engine to get out of that fire station in a hurry. It's an intriguing argument that is consistent with the notion that inflammation is a key regulator of lipoprotein metabolism in a positive way historically, evolutionary-wise, but in an adverse way in our current environment.